I'm Harlen Makemson, Associate Professor in the School of Communications, and I'm going to show an example how a student used Storify in one of my classes to do a curation about war reporting over history. And again, Storify is just one tool you can use to do curations, but this shows not a little bit about the tool, but more about how you can bring different elements into a curation. So curation is not just about finding the stuff, but telling us why it matters and giving us context. So I'm going to go to the page a student did here about war reporting. You can see at the top, some of it is her own writing. So she did sort of a quick introduction about what this topic was going to be about, both in the headline and discussing it. She's going to take from the American Revolution through the Civil War into current day conflicts at the time, Iraq and Afghanistan. So as you can see, this student brought together a number of different elements. So she found a YouTube clip. This is from a famous CBS report in the mid-1960s by Morley Safer, and so brought that in, but then her own commentary throughout talks about those are not always professionals doing this job, and then you can see other links she brought in. She brings in links from the museum. Some of you may have been to the museum in Washington, D.C. Also has an amazing website. So there is a exhibit about from war stories from there, so you can, she allows folks to have links that would take you to, again, museum content, video interviews, etc. And then she starts her narrative. So she begins sort of chronologically, which is fine, about the revolution, and finds different content about why the revolution mattered in terms of the media aspects. So she does a good job of bringing together some links from inline links, and then also bringing in links from pulling in links to full story. So Storify allows you to do this fairly seamlessly. It's particularly good for allowing you to bring in YouTube, bring in tweets, bring in videos, etc. Other tools can do that as well. But the idea with Storify, it brings it together as one. The idea is that you bring everything together as one cohesive narrative to be read as a story, as the name. The name might indicate. So this is just one way students have been able to use this, not so much in this case of the historical project with Twitter, but she did find a few things as well. So this is one example of using curation as one package to do one topic to be read at one time, as opposed to some of the other examples where you're following a topic in real time periodically throughout a semester. This is more a semester end project with this tool.